Hey everybody, it's AJ from Disney Food Blog. Today we're headed over to Magic Kingdom and we are going to do a Frontierland food tour for you. Let's get started. Okay, Frontierland is over there between Adventureland and Liberty Square. It's where you're gonna find Splash Mountain, Big Thunder Mountain, Tom Sawyer Island, Country Bears, and all those fun things. There are also a couple of great spots to eat here, so let's check those out. As always with our food tours, we're starting at the smallest locations and getting progressively to the biggest locations. So let's start with a couple of these food carts. The Mickey Pretzel and Churro cart is a little tiny cart out there that's just basically gonna sell you Mickey Pretzels and Churros. Usually the Churros come with a chocolate dip and the Mickey Pretzels come with a cheese dip. We of course love to dip our pretzels in chocolate dip and cheese dip, so I tend to get them both. That's one of my little DFB snack hacks for ya. There's really not much else to get here, but if you're looking for some Churros or you want one of those Mickey Pretzels and you don't want to go across the park, here's where you get them. Next up, the Frontierland popcorn cart. This one was super interesting for a little while when it was serving maple popcorn, but maple popcorn has gone by the wayside, and now you're going to get just regular popcorn here. And don't forget, you can also get your refillable popcorn bucket filled here as well. Next up, we'll head over to Westward Ho. These are all kind of in the same general area there over by the river. And Westward Ho is a small walk-up kiosk. There's a little grab-and-go menu here. They do have corn dogs on the menu right now. These are frozen corn dogs, so these aren't going to be your hand-dipped corn dogs that you can get over at Sleepy Hollow or in Disneyland. These are, you know, typical counter service hot dogs. We would always recommend, if you're in the mood for a corn dog, head over to Sleepy Hollow and get the hand-dipped ones instead of the ones here at Westward Ho. You can also get some muffins here in the morning, assorted chips and things like that. You can grab your coffee, your cold brew coffee, sodas, frozen lemonade, and those kinds of beverages here as well. Next, I'm gonna head over to one of the merchandise locations, to Prairie Outpost and Supply. This spot has actually a kind of bakery and candy counter. So this is another location along with the confectionery and Big Top Treats where you can get some cupcakes, some dipped crispy treats, some seasonal items. Usually they have some of those dipped marshmallows and things like that. The stuff that you can get reliably at the confectionery at Goofy's Candy Company in Disney Springs, places like that, that's what you're gonna get here at Prairie Outpost and Supply. They also have packaged candy, packaged snacks and treats and things like that. Probably not gonna be anything here that's super healthy for you, but there are gonna be some great souvenirs and some great snack credit items at Prairie Outpost, so you don't have to go all the way over to confectionery. Next up, we're gonna head over to Golden Oak Outpost. Golden Oak is a standalone sort of counter service location. They do often have chicken nuggets and fries kind of thing here. There's no indoor seating, but you can always go across the way and sit over either at Tortuga Tavern seating or at Pecos Bill's seating. Again, usually the menu is going to be chicken nuggets and waffle fries. Sometimes they change it up. They do some loaded waffle fries. Right now you can get some chili cheese waffle fries, but it's never going to be anything extensive. Sometimes they'll have a chicken sandwich and stuff like that. It's very much where you go. There's literally lines everywhere and you just need to grab something to eat. But this is the only place you can get counter service waffle fries in the park, which is kind of a unique item here. Okay, next up, we're gonna head over to Pecos Bill, Tall Tale Inn and Cafe, often known as Pecos Bill's. Even though it's not technically Pecos Bill's, it is Pecos Bill, Tall Tale Inn and Cafe, but we always call it Pecos Bill's anyway. This spot has changed a lot in the past few years. It was burgers and fries, and then it switched to kind of Mexican or Southwest inspired foods, sort of a Tex-Mex situation. It is counter service. There's tons of interior seating, a little bit of exterior seating as well. The outdoor seating is mostly covered, and so this is a great place to go if it starts to rain or if you're eating at a busy time, because there's usually enough room here to handle a lot of people. Frontierland feels sort of a Western feel here at Pecos Bill's. They do offer mobile ordering, so if you are there during a busy time or there are long lines, please, please, please make use of that mobile ordering. Very, very, very much worth it. But now that they take Disney Dining Plan credits with the mobile ordering, there's no reason not to do it. So here you're gonna get Mexican food. So fajitas, burritos, tacos. Every once in a while they have a Southwest burger on the menu. You can get a side of white queso here, which is really, really great. Love the white queso. On the kids menu, there are corn dog nuggets. So I love to sort of combine the corn dog nuggets with the white queso. Love that. They have little bite-sized churros for dessert here. And one of the most important things to know about Pecos Bills is the fixins bar. There is a toppings bar or a fixins bar here where you can sort of plus up anything you get. A lot of people will go and make a full salad out of the fixins bar at Pecos Bills. So in terms of where to eat in the Magic Kingdom, this is a good spot. It's a good location. They have decent food. If you're going to eat counter service, this is one of the better options in the park. Okay, and now we're going to head over to Diamond Horseshoe. Diamond Horseshoe, as opposed to Golden Horseshoe in Disneyland, this is Diamond Horseshoe, again, has gone through some iterations. For a long time, it was a counter service location, then it was a table service location, then it was nothing. Now it's back to a table service location. So this is where you're gonna go to get sort of a family style meal, including barbecue pulled pork, sliced turkey, smoked sausage, braised beef, salad, and some other side dishes and some desserts. So this is probably not your best table service location in Magic Kingdom. I would say this is your last resort, but it's still a very nostalgic location. There's a lot of history in this building, so we really like it, even to just pop in and check it out and take some pictures. But the food is nothing really to write home about, but it's fine. And it is currently serving lunch and dinner as a table service family style all-you-can-eat meal. So that's Frontierland, and be sure to check out our other Magic Kingdom food tours. We've got them on the site in our food tours playlist. We also are covering all of Epcot's World Showcase over there, so be sure to go check those out. And let us know in the comments what you love. What restaurants do you definitely have to go to in Frontierland or in Magic Kingdom in general? Let us know your thoughts and where you're planning to go on your next trip. Give us a like and a subscribe if you like this channel. If you subscribe, we'll be sure to let you know when those next videos come out. Thank you for watching. This is AJ for Disney Food Blog, and we'll see you real soon.